In this introduction video, I will show you how to manually enter data in your balance sheet inside the Diamond software. And to help you understand better, I will work with an example company called Power My Bike, which is a startup company. Now, let me tell you something about the startup company. This startup company will have an activity that people can lend out their bikes to each other. The location of the activity will be Europe, so it will be operational in several countries. The activity itself is operated by an app on your mobile phone and automatic payment. And if somebody wants to lend the bike, it just goes to the app and on the GPS, the bikes for lend are visible. So this is the basic activity. For this, we need to invest. We need to make a feasibility study and to see how we can make any money, because that's what it's all about. And as a startup, we want to survive the first 3 years, because most startups die in the first 3 years. 90% of the reasons is lack of capital, not good finance plan, etc. Even if it's a super troop ID, they don't live it through. So let's create a file. First thing what we do, we go to the main button and we create a new file. And now the location automatically opens. We give it a name. Borrow my bike. And what I always do, I give in also the date. So today is 2 August 2019. In this way I can see when I work on the file, and even if there is a date already inside the file itself on the extension on the PC, I still can say in what version I'm working in. So that's why I always put in the date and the year and the description, so I can see in what version of the file I'm working. So I save it on my computer. First thing that the system offers us is a choice between capital company and general partnership. In our situation, we choose the capital company. We push finish and now the system creates itself. And you see that now 3 years are being presented on the screen, 2016, 17 and 18. At least first what we do, we start adjusting the years. For that one, we go to properties, years. First year is history year 2018 on the year level. And then the forecast years, we decide to have 2019 to 2024. On the month level, we press OK. He says yes, and the system adjusts itself now. Automatically, the sheets are opened on the lowest level. You see here that the balance sheet has history years 2018 till 2019 and further on the month level. So if we scroll all the way to the right, we see that all these months are open till December 2024. So that's OK. So when we press the F5 button, as we do now, then all the years are closed and going directly to the level of year. We see also now that we started with 2016 and 18. That's not something I don't want. I just want to start with 2018 itself. So I will delete 16 and 17. I go back to the main button. I go to properties, years, and I grade up 18 till 18 as the first year. Press OK, and the previous 2 years will be deleted automatically. So again, because I adjusted the level of the time period, the system opens on the lowest level. I press again the F5 system, and everything is now smooth on your level represented on the screen. So the first thing which I want to do is I want to give in the investments of my Borrow My Bike company. So I have thought about what kind of investments I need. I prepared an Excel list, quite nice, I think. And I try to summarize up what's necessary. So when I start a company, of course, I need some material. I need a high performance laptop. And for my other employee, I need a basic performance laptop. For presentations, I want to have a beamer. Some calculations are quite wide and big to see, so I want to have a wide screen monitor, and I want to have a basic 19-inch monitor. Both monitors can be used for laptops, and the laptop can be extended with the BeamWizard presentation. And also would be nice to have an extended set of mouse and keyboard to work a little bit more comfortable and not to be convicted to the small keyboard of my laptops itself. So from each I need one, and because I have two laptops I need a double set of keyboard and mouse. Besides that, we like to call someone and each other, so we want to have two proper phones. We bought an iPhone XS and an iPhone 8. And besides that, the software we want to build, we need three things. We need an app, so the app which we run on the mobile phone for our future clients. We need a platform where the Be My Bee system runs on. And we need a database management system, so we call it a DM system. And we made a taxation about what the development of the software components will be. So the estimation for the app was being made 40,000 euro. The platform development was estimated at 50,000 euro. And the database management system for the information of our clients and our sales in the future was be estimated at 25,000 euro. So besides the quantity, if for each component I need only one, except as it was stated, the keyboard I need two. But the average price of each element I got in this row. So when I compound this with the quantity and the price, I have my total investment, and it's approximately 90,000 euros for the whole bunch. So that's one. So I need to invest 90,000 euro to get my equipment there up and running. So that money I need to get somewhere. Besides that, I will buy these investments on a certain date in a period of time. So in July, I want to start up my company. So I need my laptops. The investments have been done, will be done in a certain period of time. So besides the summary I make of what stuff I need, I also have to plan them, because on a certain date I have to pay for these items. So that's why I made an investment date period from July, August 19th till also an estimation when the software components have to be built and ready for January 2020 and December 2019. Also, what's for me important is the stuff which I buy now, they have to be put on the balance sheet somewhere. And they have to be depreciated for some years. So a depreciation time for my investments here for the hardware is between 3 and 4 years. And the software is between 10 years, 8 years and 4 years. So because I assume that the app which I let build, we can use it for more than years. Of course there will be updates, but the investment I've smoothed out middle and long term. And I think that laptops are quite rubbish, and phones as well, after 3-4 years. So after I calculate that years here, I have my depreciation time. So when I connect everything together, as you have learned in your education, you have your investment, you have your RAT value when it's rubbish. So over that one, you cannot depreciate. You connect everything together and then you have your depreciation annual. Find a nice calculator. So what we have now in the table, we see that we have an investment in the first year, the second year around 90,000 euros, and the drop of value over this drop down period of depreciation is approximately 15,000 euro a year. So this is somewhere we have to calculate, and it's quite complicated when we have to do this further in Excel on a monthly yearly basis for the future. So this information we have now, but we will not build that total structure into Excel, but we use the Diamond system to let that be calculated for us. We only have to be specific, when do we do what. So let's see how we get that stuff into Diamond. But before we want to do this, we have to structure this information. Why? I show you here in my next presentation. Because if you want to go from activity to, let's say, accountancy way of speaking, because after you have invested this in a year, you will have a bookkeeping and annual report, and that annual report will have a different structure than you have this simple Excel here. It will look like this. So on your balance sheet of your future company, you will have material fixed assets. And this material fixed assets is being divided in working equipment, which were the PCs, the laptops, the keyboards, and your beamer. And so you have your software components. And this working equipment can be sorted out in computers, support equipment, and mobile phones. And your software will be divided in applications, a platform, and a data management system, which can have a subdivision because your software support equipment can be monitors and keyboards. And then you're going to your lowest level, and that lowest level was actually your list here, but then well structured in your system. And you see them here separately. So this structure, as it will be in the future, will be also be built in Diamond. And I'll show you how we do this. So first what we do now is go to the annual report up, and we're going to our default settings, VET rates, and we just check that the average VET rate is 21%. Of course, we can do it for each row separately, but average 21%, and the VET remittance will be due on a monthly basis. So once that's done, we are giving our name, our company, some information, because the file doesn't know who is this. So on our general information here, we fill in our name. Company name, which is Borrow My Bike. So we already were so far that we build in our historical year and our forecast years, etc. And the first thing what we do, which you surely didn't think about here when you start doing your investments, is you have to do something with VAT, because these figures are exclusive VAT. VAT is taxes you get back after the investment, but you have to pre-finance it. And your system has to know what are your VAT rates. It's a capital company. And then we really start with the company itself. So we did in the VAT rates, we gave it the name, and now we're going to the balance sheet to put in some real data. So the first thing what we do is go to annual report. And of course, we want the company to have some starting capital. And the stock capital is 15,000 euro. We put it in cash here. And 50,000 capital of cash is net worth 15,000 euro. So we give that one as well in there. So you see that the diamonds will, after recalculation will drop off. So red diamonds say mistakes. When you don't have any mistakes, no red diamonds here. 15,000 euro, 15,000 euro balance sheet is equal. Then next step, what we will do is we go to our material fixed assets. Why? Remember, I go back to my Excel. We want to give in this information into our system, this information, and it will, we have to structure it like this here. So first what we do, we go from the material fixed asset and we add the work equipment and the software. How do we do this? We open this one and then we duplicate this line two times. One more, and we rename it in work equipment. And software. So from there, the work equipment, we also open that folder, and that subfolder we call computers. And when we open that folder, we have our objects. And the first object we give in here is laptops. We go into the laptops and then we go to investments. And from there we go to the new investments. Here we have to have two components. You see that we go into units, but I want to buy a high performance laptop and a basic laptop. So I need two positions to give in, so I go to my right mouse button and just simply duplicate. So you will notice that the duplication functionality will be used a lot because you can build everything you want here. It was high performance laptop, yes. Laptop. So, and the basic laptop. So now these two items exist. We open that folder to the high performance laptop. It's of course it's one unit, and this one unit has to be given in a certain time, not in a year, because you buy it in certain months where you do this. It was bestated in our Excel file that this high performance laptop would be invested in June 2019. So we open monitors. Excel, when we had to plan this monitor, let's do that. We go to June 2019. How do this? We go to the, with the mouse to the position of forecast 2019, we push the right mouse button. Now a screen pop-up is there and we just go to realization as months. Then we go to July 2019. We buy one unit and the price of that unit was €4,500. It's being calculated by units. You see here that that's well connected. We go page up and then we go to the basic laptop. The basic laptop, let's check it, was being bought in August 2019. So we go to August. One laptop, €850. And we can page up again. So now what we did now is that we did an investment of two items. A basic high performance laptop and the other one. You see here also now that here are numbers here. Now one thing which they both in common is that they have investments. Now we can also, they have the same depreciation rate. We can put this one here, but also we can go one level higher. We have the same here. We decide that they have a depreciation length of 3 years, which is 33%. So the system adjusted that rate, and they have a rest value of €20. So now basically my investment is being done. The next step what we do is, besides computer, we also have another folder which is called support equipment. So how you do this? Now again here, which is possible, we duplicate it by the right mouse button. We have a new sublevel, we call it support equipment. We open that folder and the first item we want to have is monitors. By just clicking on the word, you can type them. Monitor. So to make it more visible what I'm doing really, and don't get lost in all the structure, I doubled the both systems. So on this side of the screen I got Diamond, on this side of the screen I have my Excel, which I usually normally used to work in. So I want to have this structure built in here. So what I did first, I had this sub equipment, computer supported equipment, and then just going into the folder monitors, which I want to divide in beamer, widescreen and basic monitor. So what I do now, I open this here. I go to investments. And here I need to have three core elements. So two already there. So I will adjust one extra, duplicate it. And then I need to have the beamer, the widescreen, the 19-inch monitor, which are already in my Excel here. I go up. These three elements, I copy them and just paste them in. So here they are. So the next thing which you have to do now is tell the system what I'm doing. Beamer will be invested in a certain time of year. The beamer will be invested where it is. You buy it in November 2019. So let's go to November 2019. We buy one beamer, And the Beamer had a price of 815 euro. Done. The second item which we do is the widescreen monitor. The widescreen monitor will be invested in July 2019. So first we go to July. One unit with an investment price of 1500 euro. So then we can just continue, let the system do the work. We open 19 inch monitor. That one is being bought also in July 2019. And the investment price here is 350 euro. So we adjusted now the three components of our monitors, and the rest value of these items are 50 euro altogether. And of course we have a depreciation timetable of these three items, and which is 4 years. So we give it the 4 years here, and the system automatically converts that, transfers that to a depreciation rate of 25%. So also that part is now being done. So then we have the next item to go to, and let's go back to the structure. It was the keyboard. So keyboard was part of supporting equipment. So at the moment I see now, I duplicate it once again. And I give you the description of my keyboard, which I just copy and paste in here. For that, I also go to my investment components. This, you see that the system remembers how many specification issues you always want to have. And this time we only need to use one, keyboard and mouse set. We paste it in. We open it, and that keyboard and mouse set is being invested in July 2019. We give in two sets because we need two sets here. It's being given in here, and the investment of one set is 70 euro. So that's already being done, and then we are back at this main screen here. The depreciation rate of that item, the item is being set at 4 years, which is of course automatically 25%, which the system automatically calculates. But you can give it in as well for yourself, and then the years are being calculated. It's called reverse calculation technique, which is on board of the system of diamonds. So that one is being done as well. Oh yeah, and there is a rest value. It's being calculated on, let's see where it is, 5 euro rest value. So let's give it value as well. So, and with that last point, this part of the equipment is being done. Now we are going to our phones. And let's see where our phone was in our structure. Look it up. The phone structure was not supporting equipment, but we chose to make a category mobile phones, which is not here yet, so we have to build that one. Again, we just push the right mouse button, duplicate, and we have now another sub-level we call mobile phones. In object 1, I will type in iPhones. iPhone XS and iPhone 8. These phones are being bought in a certain period of time. we've planned to buy these phones also in July 2019. So the XS phone, it was an investment. Here we saw it already about 1200 euros. And the iPhone 8 was 700 euros. The phones have rest value of 150 euro. And we calculate the depreciation time in 3 years. And with that last overview, the total investment is being done. So we have invested now in several items, but also these items are being depreciated after you start using them. So where you want to see if your investment of that year is totally correct, you go to your financial analysis, expectation overview, and there you can look up that your investment over the year 2019 in total is 10,155 euro. Here's the software. So that we go to the folder of the software and three sub-levels, it's quite right. We have the applications, we have the platform and the data management. So we now duplicate this level 2 times. And we call them applications, platform, data management. So then these folders, they have all three, only one component. The first component of the application is the apps. The platform is called Platform for B&B. Borrow my bike. And the last one is Data Management System. System. Now we have structured that one here, and now we only have to give in our investments. So the investments we have already thought about in our Excel. So the apps we have estimated 40,000 euro, and it's being invested in 2020. Then the contract's being signed. So what we do now is that we go to 2020, we go to the years, push white mouse button, and go to the month level. So now we are in January. We go to open the applications and we give in there the investment. Because if only one application here, we can do it on the high level, but we prefer to go to the lowest level because in the future it could be so that there will be more small part application which you want to specify. So that's better to put it in a component on the new investments. We call them apps. And then we open the folder apps. We can give in the components. So it's one system in this part, and it's being fixed price of 40,000 euro. Calculated by the units, it's okay. So now we quite fast can go up again. Do the same procedure for the platform. You drill it down, we code investments to the new investment one. This component we call platform for BNB. For borrow my bike. We open that folder. You can do it with mouse clip or with page down, page up, just what kind of hotkeys you want to use. It's being also invested in the other time period. And this one is in 2019 actually. We were working in 2020, so when we scroll back a little bit to the 19 year, and we've, because standing up the forecast year 2019, open rise mouse button, go to months level, automatically the system goes for that year also to months, and then we scroll to the right to December, we put in 1 unit for 15,000 euro, and then that one's also ready. Then we go to the next component, and that is the DM system, data management system. DM system, the component also, and when we given that one in, it's being done in June 2020. Now we were already in the levels of June 2020, so June is here. We given one component of 25,000 euro. So that component is also being done. Now what you see here that I have three levels with each one separate component. So that means that I have to give in for each component now, each level, the time period of depreciation. So which was for my first applications, when you open that one here, we had a depreciation level in 10 years. So it's already there because standard the system is set here on 10, but we overtype it so it's blue, so we can see that we have given it manually. And we override here the system settings. So the second application platform is here. You go to the investments, and that one is in 8 years. We override it, 8 years. And the last one is 4 years. So there we open the folder, go to the DM and place here the 4 years, which is 25%, which the system automatically calculates. So with that total investment now being done, now my total system is being given in exactly what I'm going to do, what is going to be invested, when is going to be invested, what's the depreciation time, what's the rest value, and what will be calculated in the depreciation annual report. So when I go to the total overview, and I want to go immediately from years to from months to years, I just also can use the F5 button. And then the total year for the second time closes. And then I have an overview of what I've been doing. So I've been doing some investments here when I open the screenshot in there. But I showed you that I built some kind of structure. This structure. So, and I could imagine that you sometimes get feel a little bit lost. Okay, how is doing navigated and how is being built here? So to get that one more easy, we can open now the Explorer. It's under the page view. We open Explorer here. We pinpoint it to the screen. So the screen is divided now in Explorer screen and your Diamond screen. So in that one, you don't get lost anymore. So now I show you what we actually did. So we open here now your material fixed assets. We see here now, quite clear, your work equipment and your software. When we open these two folders, you see now you have computers, equipment and mobile phones, and platforms, applications and data management. So the computers were in a subfolder in laptops, And support equipment was there in monitors and keyboards. So the total structure which you wanted to build in the first place, like this here, you can find it back now here in Diamond. In your balance sheet, but also in your profit loss account for your depreciation, you can find the same structure. It will be explained later on, but just give you a few short insights. You have here the depreciation folder. And when we open the depreciation folder, you see that your total structure of working equipment and software is being done there. And when we open these folders, you see your depreciation for your computers. So not only the depreciation of your computers is there, but also from your support equipment and from your mobile phones. So the structure which you built in your balance sheet is also exactly the same structure in your profit loss account. So when we open the Explorer bar and I will look at this structure here, you will see that if you go to your profit loss account, actually the exactly the same structure is being built by the system itself. And not only there, but the same structure is already built automatically also in your default settings. For example, for your VAT rates. So when I go to the VAT rates for investments, material fixed assets, also my total system is here. So that means that once you start adapting the system to your activity itself, as you have built in Excel and given into Diamond, everywhere in Diamond the system is being adapted. And this is how you put in the Excel data into your Diamond file for your first steps in your startup company. Now you see how we manually enter data in your balance sheet inside Diamond FMS and how we started the startup company Borrow My Bike. So in our next video, we will continue giving data from the activity itself into the profit loss account. So thank you very much for your attention and hopefully see you next time. Bye bye.